Now, I get that this black box on your screen is probably the scariest looking thing ever, and you're like, I don't want to do it. What is this thing? It may be a little intimidating. I'm going to take you through it. And the way I like to teach is I will type, you will copy, so follow along best you can. And step by step, it'll start to make sense why we use it. Because I get that at this point, you may not even know why we are using this thing. So let's get started writing some commands, and it'll start to make sense if you just trust me and follow along. Okay, so the first command I am going to teach you is this ls here. So type ls, that stands for list. What it's going to do is it's going to list all of these words. What are these words? Well, these are different folders on your computer. Where are they? Well, let me show you another command. So I just showed you the first one, that's ls. You may want to jot that down, or I'll put notes down below, so you can always come back to this in the future if you get stuck. You always have this here. Another command, which is important to know, is open dot. No. If you're on Windows, it's start dot, but on Mac, it's open dot. And if you do open dot, what it's going to do is open up the folders on your computer. Now, it's going to all start to come together. Let me show you what I mean. So basically, what we're doing with the terminal is where my command prompt is, this is the prompt, this thing blinking, and this is where we type, right? Don't type that, but that's where you type. Where we are typing right now is we are writing commands, right? Writing commands. We're basically saying, telling our computer to do things, right? Run this file, open this file, delete this file. All the things that you do on the computer yourself, right? You come here, you make a file, you have a new file, you delete the file, right? We can do that with text. So that's part of the power of this. And over time, as you'll see, we can do it a lot quicker with text, and we can do it, you know, times 10. We can do open 10 folders at one time and do some really magical things. All right, so back to where you and I are right now. Right now, we are just opening these folders. And so everything that we do here in the black in the terminal represents things that we are actually doing on the computer, right? So you can see I have this list of folders here, and we have them here. Now, on the folders here, I can go into my desktop, right? I can click in the desktop, I can click in the documents, I can click in the downloads, right? And I can see what's in there. Same thing here with the commands. Let me show you another command. So remember, ls, we'll do that again, ls lists everything, just like this. Now, if I want to go into another folder, I do cd, and then the name of that folder. So in this case, I can go into music, cd music, and you can see it's represented here. It's saying, now we are in the music folder, right? And now once I'm in there, I can ls as well, and we have three folders. We have audio music apps, GarageBand, iTunes, and you can see kind of in our real life, in the folders here, we also have that. And you can continue to go in, I could say CD, GarageBand if I want, and go into that folder, and again, I'm here. Pretty cool, right? So we're just kind of moving around at this point. We're not doing too much else, we're just moving around. And that's what the CD create directory stands for. Now, if I want to go back, I do CD dot dot, and that's going to move us one back. You can see I just moved from GarageBand back to music, and you can do CD dot dot again, and now you can see I'm back here where we started. Does that make sense? This is going to take some getting used to. You're going to have to type these a lot and just kind of follow along. But again, the notes are down below, so when you do get stuck at a later point, you can come back to this. So far all we've done is kind of open these folders and got inside of them and moved around, trying to kind of, the things that we do with the mouse here, we're doing with code. That's all we've done so far.